Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to set up the welcome page on your Weebly ePortfolio. So we're going to go up here to the menu. We have all the pages that we created in the last video. If you haven't watched that video yet and made your pages for your ePortfolio, you need to go back and do that. We're going to go up here to the menu and click on Welcome. We're on the welcome page right now. But we're in the Pages menu. We can't add any content to our website. So to build our website, we need to click on Build up here in the menu. And this is going to give us a plethora of options that we can use to add to our ePortfolio. This includes titles, text, images, galleries, slideshows, all of these different things that we can add, YouTube videos, files. I'm going to walk you through how to create this page and also how to navigate through Weebly to add elements to your website. So, how Weebly works is you have this dotted line area. You'll see when I move my mouse over, it glows blue. We aren't going to click on Start with a Layout. If we do that, it's going to give us a lot of content that we don't need. But it says drag elements here. So we're going to grab these tiles, I like to call them tiles, and we'll just drag them over. To start for our welcome page, we're going to grab a text box, tile box, and we're going to click and hold down on what we want to add. Click and hold down, and we're going to drag it down until we see this blue line appear. The blue line tells us it's going to drop in that area. The first element that we pull over, it doesn't matter where we drop it inside of this white box, but from here on out, it is gonna matter, and I'll walk you through that. So I'm gonna let go, and it's gonna add this text box. Now in this text box, we're going to write a welcome paragraph. This is a brief welcome to your ePortfolio written to your teachers or written to anyone that you are sharing your ePortfolio with. So I'm gonna write welcome paragraph. Just as an example. In your welcome paragraph, this could include things such as, "Hello, my name is John. I am a student at Sala Community College. I am studying general education," or whatever your major is. And you can write just a little brief welcome to your website. It doesn't have to be more than a paragraph, so feel free to create this. The next thing we're going to do is we are going to grab an image box and we're going to pull that down. Now you'll see that as we move elements over, it's going to give us a few different options of where we can put it. If you pay attention to where the blue line is, the blue line tells you where it's going to drop. So you see the blue line right now is above the text box I already added because my mouse is above it. If I go below, it's going to go below it. Since it's an image and a text box, they can actually interact with each other, and I can put it inside the text box, or I can even put it to the side of the text box. You'll see a little blue line appear if I put it on either side. That will create columns. Pay attention to where this blue line is going to go, because it shows you where it's going to let go. Now, say for example, you accidentally drop an element in the wrong spot. So say I drop this image box on the bottom, and I say, "Oh no, I don't want that to go there. I want that to go inside the text box." To move an element on your Weebly ePortfolio, don't click directly on the element. Hover your mouse on top of the element, don't click, and you're going to see a little box appear up here in the corner that has eight dots in it. Looks like little stitch marks. We're going to click and hold down on that box, and that is how we will move it to where we need to go. And say we added this image to the ePortfolio and we say, "I don't want this on my ePortfolio. I grabbed the wrong box." To delete something, once again, do not click on the element. Hover your mouse over the element and go up into the corner where there's this little X. I'm going to click on the X, click on delete, and it will be removed from your Weebly ePortfolio. But I do need that image box, so I'm going to come back and grab the image box, pull it over, and I'm going to put it inside that text box. This will be an image of yourself. Now, this image of yourself that you are going to include on your e-portfolio, it doesn't have to necessarily be a professional portrait picture. It can just be a picture of yourself that you feel shows who you are. To upload an image to your Weebly e-portfolio, we're going to click on this little mountain and sun right here on the image box that we just added. So click on that mountain and sun. We're going to click on this green button that says upload a photo from your computer. And we can grab an image from our computer that we like, that we want to add. I'm going to click on this one and click on open. And that will add the image to my ePortfolio. Now, perhaps like me, I added this image and it's far too large. To resize an image on your Weebly ePortfolio, just grab this little blue dot in the corner of your image and you can resize it to where you need it to be. Think that's a pretty good size. I'll actually make it a little bigger. That's fine. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to add, I like to add a divider. What a divider is it's just a straight line. It'll add some variety and separation in your website. Feel free to use dividers and spacers to customize your website and make it look how you want it to look. And we're going to grab a title box and pull that below the line. In this title box, we're going to write the words about me. Now, in the about me section, you can include anything about yourself that you want to add to your e-portfolio. We can use text, images, slideshows, galleries. Feel free to customize it and add anything that you want to show anything about yourself that you would like to share. That is how we set up the welcome page for your Weebly e-portfolio. I hope this video has been helpful for you, and I will see you all in the next video.